Hi, it's Paul. Today I'm going to talk about counters and also a little bit about tags, because we have to pay attention to what type of tags we use when we're using counters. We're going to use a parking lot controller to practice how we use counters. Let's take a look at what I have here on this parking lot controller. I've got a couple indicator lights. One says parking available, the other one says lot full. The one in the center here says OK to enter. So that's, this light goes on when it's OK for the car to go in. I've got a couple of counters here. One is cars in parking lot, and the other is daily total. And then down here, I've simulated some sensors. This bottom one is when a car arrives, and the bottom right one is when a car leaves. When a car arrives, and I'll push the sensor, a couple things happen. This light goes blue, this counter goes up, and this one goes up. When a car leaves, the cars in the parking lot goes down, but the daily total, of course, doesn't go down because we want to keep track of a daily total. So if cars come, and if I try to bring two cars in at the same time, it won't let me until this blue light goes off. And here I've hit 5. So 5 is the limit of my parking lot. I lit up this light that says parking lot full, and this light goes off, of course. Now if another car comes, nothing happens because the parking lot's full. If someone leaves, then again there's parking available and another car can come. It's a pretty simple situation. Cars leave, cars arrive. They can only come in one at a time. And that's how it works. Okay, so let's take a look at what we need here. We've got some lights that we need to turn on and off. So those are Boolean outputs. They're either on or they're off. So we need one type of tag, which is a Boolean. Next, we've got these counters. These are not on-off, these are integers. So we need to have an integer out in order to give the information for these counters. Then we've got a blue light that goes on for a period of time. That means we need a timer. And lastly, we need two counters. One counter for how many cars are in the lot currently, and one counter for the daily total. So we're going to be using 4 kinds of tags here. We also need a few new instructions. So the first one we need is we need an instruction to count up and count down. So this counter uses count up and count down. This counter only uses count up. So we need the count up and count down. We need a timer on. And the last thing we need is we need a copy command, because we need to copy the accumulated number of, well, the accumulated number of things in our counters over to an integer output so that we can turn on these displays or update these displays. Okay, let's look at how we do that. All right, I have a blank project here. Let's first look at my tags. In controller tags, here I've got all my Boolean inputs and outputs for factory I/O. I've also got a couple new ones here. I've got 2 integer outs, int out 0 and int out 1. Go back to factory I/O to my drivers. So here I've got my Booleans, my ins and outs, and these 2 new ones, I've got my int out 0 and 1 that gives me my display numbers. So that's a little bit new. Okay, those are the tags. I'll go to my local tags, and we'll see what we have here. Here I've got some different kind of tags. So down here I've got Boolean tags, and I've got integer tags. So that's two of the kinds of tags. I've also got a timer tag here. If I expand that. Now a tag is simply a place that we store information. With Booleans, we store whether it's hot or not hot, on or off. With integers, we store a number, a whole number. With timers, we've got a few things. We've got a preset, accumulated, enable, timer timing, and the done bit. So we've got a few different things with timers. And with counters, we've got several different things that we can store here too. The ones we're going to be paying attention to are the preset. That's how high a timer counts up. The preset for one of my timers is going to be 5 because that's how many cars are in the parking lot. The daily totals, I don't want that counter to ever stop or ever finish, so I'm going to put a high number like 5,000, something I won't ever get to. So I've got my preset, my accumulated, that's how many things it's counted, and here I've got my done bit. I'm not going to use these other guys, so I'm not going to talk about them. Okay, so I've got my timers and counters, that's two types of tags. I've got my Boolean tag and my integer tag, so that's my 4 tags that I'm using. Let's go over to the main routine, and I'm going to add an input. Well, first I'm going to add a rung. Then I'm going to add an input and output. So my input here, this is going to be when the car arrives. So a car arrives sensor. And I'm just going to keep this pretty simple. So my output for that would be car arrives. That's my light. So when the sensor is pressed, it's going to light up that light. I'll put in another rung. And here my input. I'm going to use that car arrives output as my input here. And the reason for that is eventually I want to put some sort of block in here. Actually, I'll do that now. So I've got my car arrives output, and I'm going to put in a normally closed contact, and that's going to be my counter one done bit. So that way when counter one gets to 5, I'm going to not allow the counter to go up. So that means here, I'm going to go to counters, and I'm going to put in my count up. So my counter here is C1, and my preset, I've already got it at 5, and this will show how many it's accumulated. So if C1 counter is done, then this done bit will block it from going up. Okay, there's my counter. I'll put in another rung. And I want to start my timer here. So I'm going to put a timer on. So that timer is T1. It's the only one I have. My preset, I've got that at 3000, so that's 3 seconds. And that will be started by my... Oh, let's start that when car arrives again. I'll probably change that later, but for now that'll do. So there's my car arrival sensor. And that's going to have my run my timer. And then I'll put in another rung. And I want to use my timer timing. So I'll go down to T1, timer timing. Oops, I don't want done. I want timer timing. And that's going to light that blue light. Let's see, OK to enter, I think it's called. There we are. Okay, one problem I've got here is this car arrive sensor, that's just a push button. So when I push that button, it's going to enable this timer, but if I take my finger off the button, that timer will not be enabled and it's going to stop. So I need to have that timer seal itself in. And to do that, I'm going to just put in another input. And I'm going to use T1 timer timing. Okay, and what that does is when I start this timer, it's going to latch itself on or seal itself in. And that timer will keep going until it finishes. Let's see, I need one more thing. I need to put my information in the display. So I'll go and put one more rung in. And I'm gonna add ladder element. I'll put the copy command. So my source for the copy is going to be C1 accumulate, and my destination is going to be my cars in parking lot. If I can find it, cars in lot. And the length is going to be, length is going to be 1. Because I just want to copy one thing. Okay, that copy command will copy my accumulated counter to my integer out, and that's going to update my panel display. So I'm going to go up here and verify my controller, check that everything's okay. I didn't get any errors, and so I'm going to go online. All right, I'm back. We're online, so I've downloaded my new little ladder program, and if I go to factory IO, I'm just going to disconnect, reconnect, make sure everything's fresh there, and I'll put this off to the side so I can see both. Okay, when I push car arrive sensor, I get hot here, tells me car arrives, and that's working. It's lighting my blue light, so my timer's working. My count up is working. Let's see if my count down is working. That's working too. So count up works. I don't have the block in there to make sure that a car doesn't try to enter while another car is already entering, so that's missing. And I don't have my daily totals going yet, but my count up and count down are working. So here's my count up command. And here's my countdown command. So both of those commands, the count up and the countdown, both act on the same tag. I've got one counter tag that I'm using, and I've got two different commands. One counts up, one counts down. Down here I've got my copy command. That takes my counter accumulated value, and it moves it over to this integer out. And that integer out gets displayed on this little display guy here. Okay, so I'm missing quite a few things still, but those are some of the basics of doing this lab. And have fun doing it. Thanks.